For more debates, updates, and bonus clips, sign up at thebigconversation.show.
But John, I mean, let's go back to some of the really important miracles, like turning water into wine.
Yes.
Now, that one, do you think that Jesus really was in the wine business and had, you know, I wouldn't mind it right now, actually, and said, oh, yeah, this
yeah,
is
handmade.
You know, abracadabra, a really nice glass of Bordeaux. Or do you think that Jesus' presence there so filled the host with a sense of guilt and love that, you know, he said, to hell with it. I've been hiding my good wines. I'm going to bring these out. That, to me, makes Jesus a much more important person than David Copperfield.
Is this also the scientist in you speaking? Do you feel like miracles reported as literally true, like water into wine, physical resurrection, somehow go against the scientific enterprise, the way we should be thinking about the world?
Well, they go against the scientific enterprise, but I see it perfectly consistent for a Christian like, say, Ernest McMullen, would say, well, but human salvation required direct intervention by God. And so these are not scientific claims, but this is the point I would want to make. I would want to, if somebody like John says to me, I believe in a literal resurrection, I don't want to hear arguments about it was women who first discovered the tomb was empty, that sort of thing. I want to say, yes, you believe this on faith, and, you know, we differ here, but I understand where you're coming from, but we're not going to argue about that one. We can argue about other things. But
I think we probably are going to end up arguing about it. John, yes. do you want to respond?
Well, I'm amazed at your selectivity as a person that's interested in rationally sorting a thing out. The thing you mentioned about the woman has stuck in your mind because it actually is a very important piece of evidence from the point of view of Jewish people.
Totally irrelevant.
No. Well, that's your belief. Yeah. I would like some evidence that it's totally irrelevant. That's not an evidence-based statement. But
what about the water to wine?
Oh, the water
to
wine.
Should we naturalistically assume that actually it was something to do with Jesus shaming the host into bringing out his best wine? Nothing miraculous happened.
Well, of course, if you're a naturalist, you've got to assume that. You've no other option. But if you're sitting where I'm sitting, this is the very first sign that Jesus did, semion, from which we get semiotics. It's an indicator of something much deeper. And what he said at the end of it in John chapter 2 is that this beginning of his signs Jesus did in Cana of Galilee and manifested his glory, and his disciples believed on him. Their faith, initial faith, was in part a response to what he did. And I believe he did turn water into wine. I don't believe it broke the laws of nature. This is God feeding a new event in. The laws of nature can't say anything to that. But I do think it had a profound significance because that water was religious water. The religious ceremony was over. It's a 7-day wedding. And they ran out of wine, which was a social catastrophe. And what Jesus did was he brought the religious water into the middle, which would have been an increased embarrassment. Don't bring religion back into this. We're having fun. And he turned the religious water into the best wine that they could drink. It's a powerful miracle that becomes a preached sermon, because wine symbolized to Jews and to many of us is a symbol of joy. Why does the joy run out of many weddings as it's run out of millions since? It usually has to do with purification. And Christ was beginning to indicate by what he did what he was going to do about it. So I see it as an actual miracle. He's demonstrating he's the Son of God, the creator of the universe, but he's doing it in such a way as to communicate something about the way in which he's going to deal with this question.
For more debates, updates, and exclusive access to the audience Q&A video that followed this debate, sign up at thebigconversation.show.